lot of people say that I am a scientist. Yes. My friend said I am a writer. But really, I am a storyteller. And I decided to come here and to tell you tonight my favorite story. Of course, about Antarctic. But it's the story of a miracle. A miracle. Yes, a miracle. I know that scientists don't believe in miracles. I am almost sure that most of you also don't believe in miracles. Yes, I agree. But okay, let me tell. And when we finish, maybe we can talk about it is a miracle or it is not. Really, the story started with the humans. It's like a short presentation. The humans can reach the more difficult and far places of the Earth. They are the more extreme habitats. Okay, we have in the high mountains, the Sherpas, we have Tuareg in the desert, we have a lot of tribes in all the jungles, and we have inhabited all the islands of the Ocean Pacific, for example. And of course, we also have people, humans, in the Arctic, in a very cold conditions. But the unique place we never had been inhabited has been Antarctic. And now it started the tale. Once upon a time, there was a continent far, far away, surrounded by a stormy sea full of iceberg, which make impossible to go there. So it was hiding for the humanity for thousands of years, for hundreds of thousands of years. But suddenly, a sailor arrived there, more or less two centuries ago. A sailor arrived there. And what he found there? When she came back, he told what he found. Ice, ice, ice. But also, he said, the beaches are full of gold coins. No, no. He was not drunk. No, no, no. He wanted to tell about this. In that moment, seals were gold coins, because the seals were very valuable for the fur, for clothes, for woman clothes, for example. And it was plenty of seals there. So really, the beaches were covered with gold coins. But what happened the next year? You can imagine perfectly. It's the history of the conquerors. Go there. Take as much as you want, because if you don't take it, someone will take. Hundreds of seal hunters arrived to Antarctic and started to kill them. As much they kill, as much they earn. It was a slaughter. It was horrible. Those white beaches of ice and snow was covered with blood. More than 1 million of seals were killed in 4 years. Less than 4 years, because it's only possible to go, it was only possible to go to Antarctic in the summer period. So it was in 4 period, they killed 1 million and more or less all them. And when we finished with the seals, they decided, what, okay, have a look to the whales. There were whales, and the whales also means money. And we started to kill whales. We spent really 1 century killing whales. It is said that it's about 2 million of whales were killed in Antarctic in this period. But this period was also the period of the great expedition to Antarctic. And I am sure it was, we call it heroic age Antarctic exploration. Then I'm sure you remember names like Scott, Shackleton, and Amundsen. I wrote about them, and I can assure you that their histories still touch the heart and make us proud to belong to the human race. But also with this, it was a period of colonialism. The European empires were dividing Africa, Middle East, Far East, and why not Antarctic? Antarctic has nothing. It was a rock covered with ice. But okay. The ambition of the humans always are high. And it started, some countries started to make, to divide Antarctic as the other part of the world. Some were historical, territorial claims. Other was just ambition. But as you can see, there were some which are overlapping. So it was possible to make into wars, into conflict. Okay, and after the Second World War, the situation was still more complicated because the planet was divided into two blocks, capitalist and socialist. And they also wanted a piece of the cake of Antarctic. It was a very difficult moment, but suddenly scientists from all over the world decided to make a large program of research in all the planet, and especially in Antarctic, because Antarctic was more or less unknown for them. And they prepared this program, call it so-called International Geographical Year, which took place in these years, 1957, 1958. And in these years, 5,000 scientists from 12 different countries came to Antarctic to make research. And maybe the hardness of the place, the difficulty they have there, the cold, they were pushed to collaborate if they want to survive to this extreme situation. And during these 2 years, enemies, clearly enemies that had been fighting or were fighting, decided to collaborate in Antarctic, all in Antarctic, but decided to collaborate in Antarctic. Japanese, Russian, United States, British, they collaborated. Okay, it could be a kind of mystery why they did it, but they did it. But it could be something that comes and goes. But not when this Antarctic year finished, the governments said, okay, why not to continue with this collaboration in Antarctic? And they said, well, maybe we'll negotiate. Let me remind you that it was the 1962. It was a peak in the Cold War. I don't know if you remind, I am older than you. I remind perfectly the Cuba crisis. I remember perfectly because I have more or less 12 years. I remember my parents were really afraid that the next morning the nuclear wars could be started. In this moment of tension in all the planet, 12 countries decided to meet and to prepare, negotiate an Antarctic Treaty. Now, what means the Antarctic Treaty? What said the Antarctic Treaty? Be careful here. The Antarctic Treaty said, make turn the continent into a place without soldiers, without weapons, without borders. And the countries who has territorial claims decided to stop them. We call it frozen. And all then joined efforts to make the Antarctic a continent only for peace and science. And in this way that the station, the scientist station, were open to scientists of another country, which is almost incredible. Yes, because the Antarctic station are not very large. They are, let's say, small hotels of 15 rooms. And if you take, you allowed scientists from another country come to your station, you have to push out to your own scientist. But we are doing it. Jesus told me I had been base commander in the Spanish station three campaigns. In the three campaigns, we have had there scientists of another countries. I myself has been doing research in stations of another countries. This is the normal behavior of Antarctica. Let me tell what happened to me. It's curious. I'm sure you like it. It's happened to me just the year before the pandemic started. I was invited by the Bulgarian Antarctic program to do some research in its station. I went to Punta Arenas in the south of Chile, and there I joined the Bulgarian team. We took a plane from the Brazilian army, Air Force, and the plane took us to King George, is an island in Antarctica who has an airport. And there, it was waiting for us a Chilean ship who took us to the Bulgarian Antarctic station, San Clemente of Whiskey. I spent there 1 month, more or less, and later, the oceanographic Spanish ship took us to the King George again, to the airport, where it was waiting for us a Portuguese airplane who took us back to Punta Arenas. Brazilians, Chileans, Bulgarian, Spanish people, and Portuguese. In all this time, I didn't use my credit card at all. No one used it. It was a kind of collaboration between countries and between Antarctic programs, because we share generously our facilities and our logistics. This is normal in Antarctic. We started badly in Antarctic with the seal hunters and with the whalers, yes. But little by little we are changing. Yes, collaboration, coordination between countries. But I want to talk about people, because it's a special place. And perhaps I tell you one story, another history. I told you, I am a storyteller. It also happened to me. I was base commander in my station, and suddenly we have a medical emergency. And in that moment, we don't have a doctor there. So I called Professor Pimpirev, who was the chief of the Bulgarian station in that moment, and told him they have a doctor there, and he told the situation, and he was agreed, we will take to pick up his doctor to have a look to our friend. Okay, 5 minutes after this talk by radio, I was on the beach with a very expert sailor preparing the Zodiac boat, which is, okay, more or less this. This photo is not there, because when you are in an emergency, you have no time to take photos. But more or less it was the quantity of ice was this, but the waves were very strong. And it was what the sailor told me, Javi, could you see how is the sea? I have a look. It's the waves are very strong, and there is a lot of ice. We are going to risk our lives. And I told him, don't worry. I know perfectly, but we must go. The poor sailor said, okay. The boat said, we have to go, let's go. Of course, I know nothing. I was born in Madrid, which is so far off the sea as Sofia from the Black Sea. And okay, in the moment we left the beach and we started to sail to the Bulgarian station, which is very close, but it's 4 or 5 kilometers, but there is a glacier in the middle and we have to go by this kind of boats. Okay, in the moment we left, I understood perfectly that we were to take risk to our life, perfectly. And this short trip, which takes half an hour, was for me long, like 1 year. Okay, and we arrived to the beach of the Bulgarian station. The doctor with some friends were there. in special clothes, waterproof clothes, like this, more or less in the middle of the, with the water till the waist. They were waiting for us. I approached the Zodiac to the doctor, and he wanted to go up and, okay. I felt I need to explain him the real situation. And I told him the same words I have heard half an hour ago. The arid strong waves is completely full of ice. We are going to risk our life. And he said, forwards. In Spanish too, because he spoke Spanish. He do this. Soy médico. I am a doctor. So we give him the hand to come in the boat and come back. Cooperation, coordination between countries, but also friendship, brotherhood, fraternity between persons. This is Antarctic. And you remember I talk about 12 countries who decided to sign the Antarctic Treaty? Now we are not 12, we are 54. One is yours and also is my country. That we still are joining effort to make the Antarctic a place for peace and science. Don't you think it's almost a miracle? At least a small miracle. Okay. I do hope this spirit, the sample of Antarctic, the spirit of Antarctic, we can spread, maybe not all over the world, but at least some other part of the planet.